here we are. And I made it over here. Hope you did too. And welcome, everybody, to another edition of the NightLife Show. It's so good to see you here once again. And as I mentioned at the top of the show, we are here in Winter Garden, Florida, which is just a small town just west of Orlando, about 14 miles or so. And we're out here on a beautiful day. Now, I got to tell you this before we get going here. For all of you folks who are watching this show up north, we're taping this show at the end of January, and it's like 65 degrees out today. Shirt sleeves. I'm going to make you suffer up there anyway. Anyway, we're having a good time out here because we thought we'd come out to a train setting to tonight's show because we've got something special that we want to show you. Now, as I mentioned, we're here and we are doing this program from outside of the train station here in Orlando. And what we're going to do is talk about trains tonight, both large and small. So any of you people out there who are interested in trains, you might enjoy this particular program. Now, out here today, shooting this fine program here in Winter Garden, is our associate here on the NightLife Show, Mr. Rick Zimmer, who is here once again. How are you today?
Hey, I'm here. It's a lovely day, boy.
It is, isn't it?
Hearing your comments there to the Clevelandites, you know, they need to be here. This is the place to be in January.
It is a beautiful day in the neighborhood, isn't it?
It's lovely. Can you say that? Sure you can.
So we're having a good time out here. Tonight's subject, oh, by the way, Rick Zimmer, who does help us out here with the show, of course, is a professional photographer here in Orlando, so it is good to, so that's why everything is all lined up just right. So anyway, today's program is about trains. This is what we're going to do about trains today, because trains have been around for hundreds, a hundred years anyway.
Sure. Yeah.
That's right, we all, I guess, most of the young baby boomer boys who grew up back in the 50s or 60s or whatever, always had an electric train.
Gotta have that electric train. Had, that's right. Big old wide tracks, those big old silver jobs. Yeah.
That's right. That's right. O27s. Yes, Lionel trains.
Yeah, those are neat.
But I've located one of these very early Lionel train promotional films. This is not a film that was shown on TV. It was actually shown to a group of, I guess, like toy dealers and everything to show them what the brand new line of scientific Lionel trains were going to be like.
Sounds interesting. Take a look at this.
That's what we're going to do. Let's take a look back about 25 years or so to a Lionel train promotional film short. Most interesting. Take a peek at this.
Presenting the Lionel Cavalcade of Trains for 1962, Section 1, featuring six new Lionel O27 operating cars designed for double action, action in sales, action in play. This is the new Mercury capsule launching car, keyed to the interest of the space age. It's a replica of the Atlas rocket and man-carrying Mercury capsule, mounted on a special flat car launching platform. This is the new cherry picker car that moves the astronaut to the hatch of the Mercury capsule. His job done, the cherry picker backs off. Remotely triggered rocket and capsule zoom high into the air. At a predetermined height, the capsule separates from the rocket automatically, releasing a parachute, which settles it gently to Earth. Two great new cars, packed with action, and they're Lionel new all the way through. Big new motorized turntable. Excitingly different, this turntable requires no bolts or screws, no marring or cutting of the tabletop. It's surface mounted in seconds, for still another real as life Lionel touch. Now Lionel continues its merchandise policy of introducing its best-selling O27 operating cars into HO. For 1962, look what Lionel has done to the constantly increasing HO train business. The new Minuteman missile launching car. The new Sheriff and Outlaw car, shown here with the sheriff, shooting it out with the outlaw, while protecting the new gold bullion car. And simultaneously with their introduction in 027, this select group of exciting big volume items, completely new to model railroading, are also being introduced into the HO line for 62. Turbo missile firing car. The new cop and hobo car. The new rodeo car. And the new mercury capsule carrying car. And there's big news in Lionel HO locomotives, too. Really big news. Now, for the first time in HO, a Lionel steamer with whistle. Now, for the first time in HO, a diesel with horn. In the examples we have just seen, is ample proof that Lionel is maintaining its policy of keeping model railroading timely, up to the minute, and geared to the space age in both 027 and HO gauge.
We're moved over here just slightly, and I was just noticing they have big planters outside this place with the letters ACL. What's that mean, I wonder?
Well, American Civil Liberty. Atlantic Coastline Railroad. That's it. The Atlantic Coastline Railroad is what this was for. An old Florida railroad line that I don't even know if they're in business anymore. I think they're defunct now.
Huh. Interesting.
Very funky.
Yes, a funky railroad. A defunky railroad. Anyway, but we thought that we would come out here and say our goodbye here's before the time ran out.
I wanted to mention something, Kerry, before we signed off. I've noticed, what is this here?
Oh, yes.
A little something here.
Well, that's true. This is, I guess, now I think about probably the first show which I have a beard on it. And for various reasons.
Watch
one of them
razor?
Of a, that, well, perhaps, but I have not grown a beard in over 20 years. And I said it was time just so people could see what I look like with a beard. Keep it for a while. I might shave it off. I don't know.
Is a 5-year-old as you
do? Yeah, that's right. That's a 5-year-old.
But, yeah, I thought maybe we'd match now. You know, the crew should match. You know?
We all have beards here on the show.
I'm off camera. You don't see me that much, but he has a beard now, so we now have our matching look. I think it's good.
You've had a beard on and off for how long?
Oh, 5 or 6 years now, I guess, yeah.
It's been interesting. So I can see that we're rapidly running not only out of sunlight, but out of time. So we must be going. I want to thank you once again, Rick, for helping us out.
It's fun being here. Appreciate you having me again.
All right. And, of course, we'll be back again next week on the NightLife Show, and I hope that you will join us then. We have some more exciting things with the world of home video. So this is Kerry Decker and
Rick Zimmer.
Thanking you for your time this time. Until next time, we'll see you again next week. Bye-bye now. We'll be right back.